Hello, my name is Martin. I'm from Juice and Hobby, and today I'm here to show you our new product, CX17. So let's have a look first of all at the transmitter itself. This is the transmitter, 2.4 gigahertz. You can see that there is attachable smartphone holder bracket, and it is adjustable, so you can fit your phone over here. And it means there is a phone application which you can use, and you can get your FPV, Wi-Fi FPV, a real video transmission. Well, if you have a look here, you can see that it is expandable as well, so for anyone whose hands are a bit bigger, maybe much more comfortable using this transmitter while having expanded arms. To mention another thing here, which I think very important, there is a left-handed and right-handed throttle modes, and they are switchable, so you can switch from left-handed to the right-handed throttle mode. There is a button here which allows you for auto takeoff and auto landing. On left-hand side there is a picture and video button. Another thing to mention is that the drone itself can do flips and rolls. There are three flying modes, choosing the different flying modes, it will adjust the speed of the drone itself. So this is CX17. As you can see, the drone itself is pretty small. I think it's something roughly about 10 centimeters. There are inbuilt propeller protective gear here to protect the blades. In the front there is a camera, in the back you can see the Wi-Fi signal antenna. Another very interesting thing to mention here, the new type of the battery, no wires anymore. You can just directly plug it into the drone, secure that, go flying, and to remove is pretty easy as well. There are two points here in the middle which you have to press, and it is pretty easy to remove the battery as well. The flight time should take roughly about 7 minutes. Again, it depends on how aggressively you do fly. And as I have mentioned, that there is a Wi-Fi antenna in the back, it means there is a Wi-Fi application as well. So I suggest now we have a look at the Wi-Fi application, and there are some new really nice features you're going to be interested in. Let's have a look at the application itself now. So first of all, let's turn on the drone. There is a switch in the rear. You'll see that the lights are flashing. Turn on the transmitter, move your throttle up and down in order to link the transmitter with the drone, and now they're linked. So we can actually fly this drone right now straight away without phone and application. So for example, if we want to arm the motors, we can do it, we can use two ways. There is a button on the left, auto takeoff, or we can arm them manually. And as you can see that the motors are spinning now, we can start flying. Actually, a really amazing thing here to mention is, guys, the motors spin and the so quietly that it is really hard to hear any noise coming from the drone. So let's stop the motors. So as we can see, it is linked. Then we have to go to settings here, Wi-Fi, and when we're in Wi-Fi we'll see that there is an option, the device called CX17. Let's connect and wait until it connects successfully. It says connected, great. Then we go to the application here, press the application, enter the application. You can see there is help, setup. You can see there's some settings here we can change. And when we press start, here you go, we have the controller interface, and it's already connected. You can see that there is a real video transmission, FPV, Wi-Fi FPV, and obviously there are many functions here. So picture, video, we can see the pictures and videos which are stored, the gravity sensor, we can calibrate our gyroscope using the application too. We can change the modes, the speed modes, make it fly faster. VR, it split the screen into two, so we can add the phone into our VR goggles and enjoy different FPV experience. If we press here, it turns the screen, and this function here with an eye cancels the controller interface. So if we cancel the controller interface, then we can use the controller to control the drone, which is in case we want to use the transmitter to control the drone how it flies. The last function here, this is a trajectory mode, and this is a new feature. If we press that, we'll see that it cancels half of the screen. So while flying, while it's hovering in the air, what we can do, we can press this button and then we can draw the line. So what the drone will do, it will follow the trajectory line. So for this function, we do recommend you to choose a very spacious environment without obstacles. We can do, I think there is a front flip if we press this button here. And another very, very interesting thing here is this button here, selfie mode. So how it works in selfie mode? So first of all, we have to be sure that the drone's rear is facing us, and when the drone is hovering in the air, we can press this button here, a selfie mode button. So what the drone does, it will turn 180 degrees, so it will turn and the camera will be in front of us, and then we can snap a picture, and it will take a picture and save it. So this is the selfie mode, which is, I think, pretty cool new feature, and pretty easy to use as well while having it on application. Then obviously we have two functions here in case we want to use just an application to control the drone without the transmitter: auto takeoff and auto landing.